Hi, good morning, Vananda. Now we can discuss about evolution. Last class we can discuss about the theories. What are the theories? The theory of special creations, panspermia, abiogenesis and biogenesis, catastrophism. And also we can discuss about the regarding to the chemical evolution. I already said that. Chemical evolution. That's why biological evolution is came from the chemical evolution, that is explained by Oparin and Halliday. Now this theory experimentally successfully proved by a scientist, that is Stanley Miller. He can done the experiment in his laboratory, and then in this experiment what we can know means he can take a spark chamber. So many times they can ask this question regarding to the compounds. It is very important to keep in mind. This one is the spark chamber. For this spark chamber I can draw a rough diagram. In this spark chamber, one side we can connected with a round flask filled with water, and it is heated with 800 degree centigrade. Why it can take 800 degree centigrade, we will discuss later. Now the water vapor is coming out, and another side it is connected with a condenser, and this one is a condenser. In spark chamber we can connected with the electrodes for electrical discharge. This is the electrodes, and then here a collector is present. See, in this spark chamber we can take methane, ammonia, water and hydrogen. Why we can take like this means these are all of the conditions of the primitive atmosphere or reduced atmosphere. At that time the temperature is how many degrees centigrade? 800 degrees centigrade is present. That's why one side we can take a water and it will be heated up to the 800 degrees centigrade. Through that the water vapor enter into this direction and enter into here. If you apply the electrodes here, the spark formation is takes place. Here the mixtures contain methane, ammonia, water and hydrogen. Then it will be, the mixture is enter into here, and here the condenser is there. Condenser is like a cooling manner, and finally in collector you can get the compounds. The first compounds are the sugars, that is sugars, and also they having a amino acids, alanine, aspartic acid and glycines are formed. These are the amino acid. Later it can done the experiment repeatedly, they can get sugars, lipids and nitrogenous compounds is formed. Based upon this experiment it is 100% proved that the first life is originated from the chemicals. That's why biological evolution is came from the chemical evolution, experimentally proved by the Stan Miller experiment. In this experiment you can remember this, they can diagrammatical representation they can give. This one is the A and this one is the B and this one is the C. Or mostly they can ask what are the combination can be takes in the spark chamber. That is very important here. And the way of the temperature, what is the use of the condenser. It is a very important one. Now, here I said the biological evolution is came from the chemical evolution. It means from the chemicals, first life form is formed, later it can undergo division, simple form to present complex form type of organisms is present. That is the concept. Here, first, how the life is formed, that is according to the biological evolution. In biological evolution, the first one is the protobionts, and the second one is the formation of living organisms. Formation of living organisms. The first one thing, protobionts. What is mean by protobionts? Mean, suppose a complex statement is very important. A complex organic molecules aggregated and form large lipid droplets, that is called as a coagulatus. What is coagulatus? A complex organic molecules, they all will be aggregated, form a large droplet. That large droplets is called as a coagulatus. Now, this one is a coagulatus. Here, this coagulatus having a chemical organs is present. That chemical organizer that is called as a free gene. Chemical organizer is called what? A free gene. Now, this free gene, I can write like this shortcut, free gene having a attracting capacity. It can attract the surrounding molecules. It can attract the surrounding molecules and they can form a lipid layer. And then inside they having a protein with having a enzyme, and also they having a multiplication function is present. Keep in mind, a free gene, they having a attractive nature which is present in the surrounding molecules. It will be attracted and they can form a lipid layer. Inside they having a protein. The protein indicates that it is an enzyme. They having a multiplication function is present. Now, here, after that, this will be called as a protobionts. After that, what will happen means formation of living organism. See, this free gene absorbs the heart dilute soup. What is meant by heart diluted soup? Means here I already said on earth they having so many depressions is there. That depressions is filled with water. At that time the temperature is 700 to 800 degrees is present. Now in this water they having hydrogen, they having methane, and they having ammonia, and water is present. Now the water, they having these are the combination is present, and the temperature is more. That's why that is called as a hot diluted soup. That's why the free genes, what are the substances is present in hot diluted soup, it will be absorbed, and then it will be having a turns to prokaryotes. prokaryotes. Now this early prokaryotes having a 1-2-2 DNA is present. The first formed ones are the anaerobical nature. It can gains the energy, by the process of fermentation. Later, during the evolution, the life is going on, chemoautotrophs are formed. Chemoautotrophs means in the bacterias, mainly iron and sulfur bacterias, carbohydrate synthesized enzyme is present. This carbohydrate synthesized enzyme is there. By the using of this enzyme, first it can absorb the carbon dioxide into the body. By the using of that enzyme, what is that enzyme? Carbohydrate synthesizing enzyme. By the using of this enzyme, it can produce the carbon dioxide and water. Not only that one, they can get the sugar molecules. By the using of this sugar molecules, it can get the energy. And then after that, it will be turns to a chlorophyll bacteria. Here chlorophyll bacteria is two types. One is the unoxygenated, without oxygen the organisms will be survive. And then now present cyanobacteria. These are the chlorophyll bacteria, these are the aerobical bacteria. That's why these are two types. One is the anaerobical one is present, another one is the aerobical one is present. This cyanobacteria, it can release the oxygen, free oxygen into the environment. At the time, aerobical organisms, that will be called as a eukaryotes. That's why first the prokaryotes is formed, later eukaryotes is formed. Before that, here I said universe is formed 20 billion years ago, Earth is formed 4.5 billion years ago, and acellular forms, this is the free genes. Free genes are the acellular forms. Acellular forms is formed 3000 million years or 3 billion years ago is formed. And then cellular forms, these are the eukaryotes and prokaryotes. These are formed 2000 million or 2 billion years ago, cellular forms are formed. Later, this is the simple form. The simple form is converted to the complex form means, first one is the cellular level to the tissue level to the organ level to the organ system level. This type of levels can be seen in the animal kingdom. Last year, you already studied about that animal kingdom. The first phylum is what? Porifera. What level? Cellular level. The second phylum is the cnidaria. What level? Tissue level. Ctenophora, tissue level. And then platyhelminthes, it can choose organ level and also organ system level. Nematoda, organ system. From the nematoda to annelida, arthropoda, mollusca, echinodermata, hemichordata, chordata. These are all of the organ systems. You know, in chordatas, they having a urochordatas, cephalochordatas, vertebratas. In vertebratas, we having a pisces, amphibians, reptiles, apes, mammals. This is the simple level to the complex level. The organisms which can show so many diversity on the surface of the earth. Next class, we can discuss about the remaining topics.